Got my little shorts and my little crop top going on.
And I have no idea how to get there, so I'm just walking aimlessly.
Good morning, good morning, good morning, guys. So I am at the airport, getting ready to begin my journey to Grenada. This is going to be the first time that I've been back to Grenada since 2019, so that was before the pandemic. And I am super, super excited because not only am I going to a place that I love, Grenada, I absolutely love, I'm also getting a chance to, like, you know, showcase my work, which is like super, super exciting. So yeah, I can't wait to get there, be reacquainted with things, and like be able to show you guys everything from my eyes. Some of the reasons that I love Grenada so much. And yeah, I'm just really looking forward to this trip. I'm so blessed for the opportunity and I can't wait. So thank goodness my flight was delayed because it gave me time to pack and sleep, since I just packed this morning. It's been a crazy past few days, but this airport is a zoo, man. An absolute zoo. Still waiting to board, but hopefully all should be good soon.
I just got called out, yo.
Call me Melissa. Melissa?
Yeah. Full government. Hello today, Miss Rose.
All right, so I've made it on the plane. The flight is about 5 hours from New York to Grenada, so people are still boarding the flight, and I'm just hoping it's going to be a smooth flight, and once I land, everything's going to be so great.
And a little less than 5 hours later, it was touchdown in Grenada. And after collecting my luggage and leaving, I was immediately greeted by someone from the Grenadian Tourism Authority, which was so cool. And then I waited before we went to our hotel, which would be the Sandals Grenada Resort.
Second time? I will not speak. So hi, how many persons here for the second time?
This is my fourth.
Finally arrived, and as soon as we got there, we were catered to with hot towels and fresh cocktails, all while we waited to go to our room. So I made it to the resort. They treat you well when you check in, but now I gotta look for like where all my peeps are, and the people that I'm supposed to meet, they sent me to some room, and I have no idea how to get there, so I'm just walking aimlessly. So apparently my instructions were actually to wait for my butler to escort me to my room, but I had no clue, so I just kept going until the butler finally found me.
I feel like they sent me in the wrong direction. Like, look at me sweating, yo. Like, is that what is drink? I'm sweating, but I'm drinking this drink. I'm gonna take the drink though.
Melissa, welcome to Sandals Grenada, and she is one of our butler elite guests, and we're going to give her some champagne. All right, welcome, Melissa. Here you are. Wonderful. All right.
Nice, thank you.
Here you are. Cheers.
Hey, cheers. Arrival.
So
Then it was time to eat, so my butler escorted me to Spices, which is one of the restaurants on the resort. And I started off with a drink, a nice cocktail, and some bread before going ahead and ordering my meal.
Hey, so I actually missed the cocktail hour because my flight came in late. So I'm just having a little dinner by myself. Well, when I say missed the cocktail hour, they had a cocktail hour for everybody that's on a trip. But like I said, I missed it because I came in late. So I'm here at one of the restaurants on the resorts. About to get me a little something to eat, then go back to my room, take a shower, and get ready for the bed that I'm going to tonight.
So for my appetizer, I had this little shrimp salad, which was pretty good. And for my main entree, a little grilled pork chop dish, which was also nice. Okay now, so here's a little tour of my room. It's nighttime now. I usually like to film my room during the day, but because one, like I said, I got there late, and it was all kind of hectic of trying to find the room and then not realizing that my butler was supposed to take me to my room, and then I was hungry and hot, a whole bunch of stuff going on. So I didn't really get to show the room before. So here's just a little brief tour of the room. It's quite cozy, if I do say so myself. And yes, I do like mirrors. I have a thing with mirrors. So when I see myself in the mirror, I may or may not just do a little jig. Getting ready to hit my first official Fete for Spice Mass. It's a Fete called Casamigos. I love this little cute number I put on. I like to be cute but simple and comfy. All right, y'all, so I'm ready for my first Fete. Got my little shorts and my little crop top going on. Don't ask me why I'm so stupid. I'm tired, I'm not gonna lie, I am tired, but hey, only live once, and we're gonna hit greens running. So the first Fete is called Casamigos. I'm not sure what kind of Fete it is, to be honest. You know, sometimes they could be drinks inclusive or whatever, they have performers. I'm not sure, but I'm going to go, I'm going to check it out, and I am going to have a time. Me and my tired self, so. Not me leaving my room and forgetting to spray mosquito repellent. I went right back and sprayed that ish because I don't mess with the mosquitoes. Them mosquitoes in Grenada is different. They is different. The very first time I came here, my legs were tore up. We ain't doing that no more. Okay. And then we made it to Casamigos. Why, thank you.
I've been drinking rum since morning. Excuse me if I'm falling down. Alcohol in the system.
And a lot of times at these parties, even if nothing is included, you will get free shots offered. And that is what was happening here, and I made sure to take my shot. I swear a mosquito bit me in my scalp. Oh my god. And I should have probably sprayed my feet because I'm pretty sure I got bites there too. But hey, I am tired, okay? A girl is tired. But you know, I still went out and I enjoyed myself for a little bit. Casamigos was all right.
I felt that, I felt like, well, one, they did not play a lot of Grenadian music, which I always find is weird when I go to places like, I'm in said country, why am I not hearing said country's music? You know what I'm saying? Like, whatever. By the time that we were leaving, though, because we left early, because we were tired, they started to play more Grenadian music, but I don't know. And people were just more like vibing, kind of like, you know, head bop, and no one was really like, you know what I'm saying? To like keep me up because I was tired. But it is what it is. It was cool to get out. I'm glad that I went and hung out for a little bit. Now I am going to take off this makeup and take my behind to sleep because the girl's tired. I've been up since 3 o'clock packing, which was my own fault, but hey, whatever. And then the whole situation with the flight. And I didn't sleep on the plane because it's very difficult for me to sleep on planes. So I'm tired and we gotta be up or leave here for 9:30 for the excursion that we're going on. So I'm gonna get some rest, a little bit of rest. And today's gonna be a long day. So let me get my little rest in and be rejuvenated so we can get through the day and enter Grenada, ay. It's Friday morning now. Well, it was Friday morning when you saw me last. Just coming in from the Fete. But I was tired. I feel rested now. I got about 5 hours of sleep, which isn't too bad. Obviously, if I could sleep more, that would be great. But I got 5 hours and I feel good. So, yeah, that's great. So now we are getting ready to go on an excursion tour. Some waterfalls and some other things that, you know, are pretty cool about Grenada. So I'm actually ordered breakfast for my room because, you know, since I got in late yesterday and it was just like bang, bang, bang after, I didn't have a chance to like get my stuff out and really gather myself together. So I did that and I decided to order in breakfast so that I could have time to do my stuff and not have to rush and be able to do everything I need to do so I can make the tour on time and not miss that. So yes, that's what I'm doing now. But so far everything is cool. It's really cool. Like, I'm really enjoying this hotel. This resort is amazing. I haven't had a chance, obviously, to really go and explore because of what happened yesterday and stuff. But after I get back from my tour today, I do plan on walking around a little bit and seeing stuff. It's on the beach and it has like all cool things. So yes, I'm gonna do that. And then let's just make sure this coffee's good. And then we have some other activities later. Tonight is Soca Monarch. I love those kind of things, so I'm excited to go. I went to Soca Monarch in Grenada once, the very first time that I came to Grenada, and that was in 2017, and it was amazing. Like, words can't even express it, so I'm really excited to go. I'm not up to par too much on my Grenadian soca. I have to admit right now. And that's another reason why I was kind of upset last night, because I felt like, you know, they weren't playing much Grenadian music. And if they did play it, it wasn't like new Grenadian music. I'm like, hello, Soca Monarch, it's tomorrow. Let us hear the tunes. It is what it is.
So yeah, I'm excited for that. And yeah, I'm gonna eat my breakfast now and then head off for this tour. So everybody in the crew, we made our way onto the shuttle bus and we made our way up the road, and our first stop was Clark's Court Rum Distillery.
Welcome to the Grenada Distillers Limited, which is the home of Clark's Court Rum, the island's number one rum. We were first opened in 1935, but as the Grenada Sugar Company, producing sugar and molasses on a large scale. However, in 1985, the sugar industry around the Caribbean ceased, so we had to stop making sugar and molasses, but we never stopped making alcohol. On this tour today, I will be taking you step by step, letting you see how the sugar and the molasses was made before, and a little bit on the now rum distillation process.
Distillery, either as a world-class distillery, a master-class, or just a first-class distillery.
Thank you. Thank you. Somebody take a next shot. Let me get you taking a shot. Wait.
Thank
I can't
you.
See you. Okay, let me get you taking a shot.
The smell is just...
I don't like you. Your turn. You like it?
That's so good, the black gold.
Yeah, try this one.
Is it good? The black gold.
It's good, right?
They are trying the fifth strongest rum in the world. Go ahead.
Which one is this? Yes, please.
So how was it?
Then I also tried the Shandy rum, which was so, so good.
Yeah, you could do another day.
Even with, you could take camomile when you're doing your syrup, like whatever syrup you use, then you could just
What about Shandy for the flavor addition? And after that tasting, it was time to head to the next stop, which was Fort Frederick. And the views from here are just absolutely stunning. Then we got a brief tour of the site, and again, because the views from on top of here are so gorgeous, we just had to take some photos. Then it was out to our third stop for the day, House of Chocolate. And this is a cute little museum that features all things made with Grenadian cocoa. So we got a brief lesson about the cocoa and how it's broken down and the things that can be made from it, like cocoa butter. And it felt so soft on my skin. Then we also got a sample of hot cocoa tea.
Good. Did you have this?
Yeah.
I was careful not to burn myself because it's hot.
Thank you.
House of Chocolate, we were down to our last stop for the tour, which was Annandale Waterfalls. Now the waterfall, it's really, really gorgeous, and you can go for a swim in the water if you'd like. I ended up just going in the water up to maybe my thighs, but I didn't actually go swimming. I think because of the time of the day that we went, it was later on in the afternoon, there was just so many people there. And I just kind of like to have, you know, a little bit more space. But it was so cool to be there and refreshing because it was just so hot anyway.
Hey y'all, so I'm back from Annandale Falls now. Or just from the tour altogether, but Annandale Falls was the last stop. Overall, it was a good time. It was a good time. I'm a little teed off right now though. My drone took off with great signal when I was by Annandale Falls. And then it got mid-air and started blinking red and was like, it lost signal. It crashed. I still have the drone. For the most part, it's intact. But the propellers are a little chipped. And I didn't bring the extra propellers with me because I didn't think I would need them. So we'll see what happens. I'm gonna try and see if it can still fly at all while I'm here, but yeah, I'm a little perplexed about that, but what are you gonna do? So now about to offload some footage because I took a lot of footage and everything's filling up, so I need to offload some footage and then get ready. We are going to go to an official welcome with the Grenadian Tourism Authority this evening, and then after that, Soca Monarch. So good times ahead. Hey guys, so I'm dressed and I am headed to the press event now. It's by the beach. I'm trying to find where the beach is. Well, this should be good. The vibes, the music was really going, and everybody that was playing an instrument, they were really into it. So, you know, then I had to go and take a few photos of my dress that I love so much before the sun set. And then, as more guests started to arrive, we were treated to a show full of traditional masqueraders, and it was just so wonderful to see. Few drinks. Nice.
to my room so I can prepare for the big night of Soca Monarch.
All right, guys. So I am getting ready to go and meet the bus now, the van, everybody else to go for Soca Monarch. It's groovy and power. Yes. So yes, I think I mentioned before, I've gone once in Grenada. There are the times I've been in Trinidad, but it's the first time, the second time I'm going to one in Grenada, so I'm excited. It should be a good time. Good time.
He's like, I can open it now.
And on the way to any event, the crew always had laughs and jokes in the shuttle. So this is Joy. She is super funny and she's giving her best impressions of different accents.
UK accent, let's go.
Okay, so the UK, yeah, what you need to know, yeah, is that it's real smooth, right? Real chill, you know, someone proper fit.
I need a man that's just proper fit, you know.
The London southern accent wasn't that bad.
She's trying.
Okay, so then we finally made it to the stadium and we got there just in time as the groovy Soca Monarch winner from 2022 was on stage defending his crown. So right now what's happening is the groovy part of the competition, and there were already some performers that had already come on that we missed, but people are now really still starting to roll in. We are actually in the VIP section, which is closer to the stage, and Gemma is behind and you'll see that soon. But yeah, so people are now starting to roll in. A lot of people tend to come a little later for power as well. I mean, there's a lot of people there now too, but you know, people are continuing to come because it's a long night, especially if you want to stay for power. It's a long night. Don't mind me, y'all. I was just so excited to be there because I love these kinds of things, even though I didn't really know the words at the time, but I know them now. Now this is Boise performing, who won this year's competition. As you can see, the crowd was loving him, so it's no surprise that he took home the crown.
Don't be a man, could be 99 times. Never forget about the one time.
So after the groovy portion was finished, there was a little bit of an intermission where some artists like Vaughn performed on stage for a bit as the crowd and everybody was gearing up for a power soca to come. Now, the power soca part of the competition, it is a completely different kind of energy. I mean, you can just see it, like the fire, the flames that are blowing, and everybody just, they're just hype. It's really hard to explain. It's something that you really need to experience for yourself. But trust me when I say it, it's an amazing, amazing experience. And one of my favorite moments for the night was when it was time for Tal Puri to come on stage now. Tal Puri is legendary in this jab music scene, okay? And they were calling for him, and his entrance, the way he jumped off the stage, just check it out. I say the energy for power just gets different. It's a totally different energy. Like, they're on the fences, they're jumping, like, it's crazy. And believe it or not, it gets crazier than this. Like, I love it. Many other performers that came on and did their thing on stage. And like I said, as the night continued to go on, the crowd just started to get more hype. It was, again, just something you gotta be there to experience. And yes, it was raining off and on. Sometimes the rain was coming down extremely heavy, but that don't stop anything. The show must go on. But again, there were so many great artists that took the stage. Honestly, I don't envy the judges because it was hard to pick. I mean, everybody just performed so well. But you know, there can only be one winner, and the night belonged to Tara the Governor.
Hurry, please don't make it up to me, but take off it. Don't do the best now. an amazing night. I think it must have ended around 3, almost 4 o'clock the next morning, but it was worth staying the entire time. I mean, just look at me. I'm just having a ball. Rain, didn't matter, sweat. Amazing, and everybody was just there to have fun and vibes out. It's something that you just have to be present to really and truly understand the feeling, but I enjoyed myself so much, and it was a great way to end day 2 of this beautiful trip to Grenada.